Isaiah 6:3, and the pillars in the temple begin to shake. In Acts 16, Paul and Silas is on a ministry trip. They've been preaching Jesus, him crucified and raised from the dead. Somebody shout, you ain't preached until you've preached that. And they're preaching Jesus crucified and raised from the dead. Miracles is following that message, because this is the word. He confirms with signs following, Mark 16:20. If you think about it, up to that point, that's all they knew to preach. So that is the word. There's a cross connection to his power. They weren't preaching a lot of stuff. They were just preaching Jesus crucified, buried, and raised from the dead. And devils were coming out, leaving and screaming. People were being healed. The dead were being raised. And most importantly, people were getting saved. And in Acts 16, man, they're walking through, sitting there preaching Jesus. And for days, there was a woman possessed with a spirit of witchcraft. The Bible called her a soothsayer. Somebody say a soothsayer. She was like your modern day psychic. And she brought her masters much gain. Somebody shout, she merchandised the people. And she soothed them. She didn't give them messages, she'd give them massages. Little spiritual massages. Somebody shout, she soothed them. Even if they were in their sin, she just soothed them and says God understands, and just spoke conviction off of them. Come on, there's a lot of soothsaying going on today. People tell you what you want to hear. Come on, and still let you just live any old loose sinful way you want to. That's a spirit of witchcraft. Come on, somebody. And she followed Paul and Silas many days. And while she followed them, she'd cry out. And she'd say, these be the men of God that show us the way of salvation. Look at your neighbor, say, that was absolute truth. The soothsayer, the one possessed with a spirit of divination, witchcraft, and that word divination is where we get the word python from, for it comes from the Greek word pathos. Come on, somebody. It's a spirit that comes to constrict the breath of God. Come on, somebody. A constrictor of this type, a python, amen, comes with its clammy, scaly body, not to devour it with its mouth, but with the squeezing power of its body to constrict and suffocate until there's no more breath, until there's no more life. And I'm telling you, that soothsaying spirit has been in the modern church too long. I've come to cast that snake out tonight, because that's why some can't praise him no more. That's why some ain't got no life in the sanctuary no more. The sanctuary looks lifeless and powerless, but I've come to cast that devil out in the name of Jesus. Hear the Holy Ghost. And as they're walking through that city, that woman, somebody shout, a demon-possessed woman. I prophesy at this church, the hour is upon us. The devil will be seen being casted out of people again, like he had been in times of old in this place. Devils, I hear the Holy Spirit saying years ago, were cast out in this ministry. And if you'll hear the words that I have sent thee and am sending you, even the words that are hard times for you to even hear at moments, if you'll receive them and respond, I'll give you power over the devil, and you'll see people get delivered by the masses, says the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. But hear this, she's saying right things, but her heart ain't right. That means you can say right things and your heart still not be right. Hello? Amen. She said, these be the men of God that show us the way of salvation. They were preaching Jesus. But Paul, after her doing this many days, grieved in his spirit, turns, and he don't speak to the woman. See, some folks thought I was talking to people last night. I didn't preach to just some personality. I was preaching to principalities last night. Hello? I've been attacked and accused already on social media. Come on, somebody. But the Holy Ghost told me that was coming. I even spoke that last night by his spirit. It was. But listen, this is amazing. He didn't speak to the woman. He spoke to the spirit. Yes, Some of you can get victory in your life if you'd quit looking at Sister Sandpaper and Brother Bucket Mouth. Come on and remember that you're not fighting personalities. You're fighting against principalities, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Come on, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness in high places where the rulers of darkness are, according to Ephesians 6 and 12. It ain't your employer you're fighting with. It ain't the people in your family that you really fighting with. Somebody shout, there's a devil loose, and you better address him as such in the name of Jesus. Amen. Paul didn't say a word to her, but he spoke to the Spirit. And sometimes when men of God, women of God speak to spirit, some people, amen, mistake it as it being spoke to a person. But he didn't address her, he addressed that devil. Hallelujah. And he said, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. Somebody's shouting, the devil come out. Ain't it amazing? Some devils are more obedient to the man of God's voice than some of the saints sitting on the pew are. Them devils obeyed and come out of her. She couldn't divine no more. She couldn't make her masters no money no more. And so they take hold of Paul and Silas. They beat them. Somebody shout, they beat them bad. Look at your neighbor and say, they beat them, but they didn't beat them. They were beaten, but they weren't beaten. Come on, somebody. How do you know? Because when they stuck Paul and Silas in that rat, roach infested prison, come on, somebody, not like the prisons of today with air conditioning. Amen, glory to God, and running water and plumbing. I'm talking about the prisons of this time. Most of them, often, amen, were underground. Some of them, amen, and the sewage of the city would run through the prison. Can you imagine the stench and the bacteria and the smell? Them with open wounds all on their back, they've been beaten and flogged. Hallelujah, because they cast the devil out of somebody and they're up to their waist in human waste. They're shackled to the walls. There ain't no lights nowhere. They can feel stuff crawling on them. Needless to say, their flesh is so beaten, the only reason they're still standing up is because the chains is holding them on that old cold, clammy wall. And all of a sudden, somebody said midnight. Look at your neighbor, say, midnight ain't really night. Tell them, say, midnight's a.m. Last time I checked at 12 a.m., it's morning. I read in Grandma's Bible in Psalms 30 in verses 5 said, weeping endureth for a night and joy comes in the morning. Some of you been looking for the daylight to determine whether it's morning, but that don't mean it's morning. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, don't be deceived by the darkness. Even at midnight, it's morning. Somebody ought to give him a morning shout. Give him a morning praise. Don't let the darkness stop you now. At midnight, I'll rise and give thanks unto you for your righteous commandments. Psalms 119, verse 62. David said, I'm going to get up at midnight and give you praise for your word. Somebody say a midnight praise. I call it a middle praise. Remember how Joshua, Levite priest, he took the Ark of the Covenant across old muddy River Jordan. Hallelujah. And the waters stood up on either side and they walked across on dry ground. And when they all got on the other side, hallelujah, the Bible said that Joshua said, hold on. This is Marvin translation. Don't look for it at your local bookstore. He walks back down into that river and he lays down 12 stones. Whoa, forever. One of the elders of the tribes of Israel. Somebody shout, he built an altar right in the middle of that river. No wonder. Hallelujah. When Naaman listened to the prophet of God, hallelujah, Elisha, and went down there and dipped 7 times, he came up whole. Because Joshua, many years before, had sanctified that river. Somebody shout, he gave God a middle praise. Look at your neighbor. Say, you ought to build an altar right in the middle of your darkest time. That's where you ought to praise him at. Somebody give him a middle praise. Hey, hallelujah. give him a middle praise. God said, if you can praise me like that now, that's a cue to you. That's an indication to you, prophetic, that you're almost out of this. You're almost over this. At midnight. Somebody shout, at midnight, it's still morning. Don't let it deceive you. Paul and Silas chained in that wall in that prison. The Bible said, verse 25 of Acts 16, that at midnight they began to pray and sing. Look at your neighbor and say, if you ever start praying, you'll start singing. Some of us don't praise because we don't pray no more. If you got an altar in your life, if you really got an altar in your life and you talk to him, you after a while, you can't help, you can't stand yourself. You'll worship him. The reason we don't praise him, we don't talk to him like we used to. They prayed. And then I like King James Version, but that's the only one I've ever quoted from anyhow. It's always made pretty good sense to me if you read it in the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And I read that one day and it read me, because in Acts 16 and 25 it said they prayed and sang. Look at your neighbor and say, how long has it been since you sang? Tell them, say, I know every Sunday you sing, but how long has it been since you sang? Come on, South Georgia, everybody, anybody from South Georgia like I am? Hallelujah, we don't just sing, we sing. Somebody say sing. There's a difference in singing. Anybody can sing it out of the book. Anybody can sing it off of the wall. Anybody can sing it, but not everybody wants to sing it. Somebody shout, there's a big difference in singing and singing. You can sing about a God you don't even worship. Hallelujah. Wow. I'd rather hear somebody that couldn't even carry a note, bless God, much less in the shower, yet on the stage. But if it come out of their heart and they was worshiping him, come on somebody, because I've heard some that could sing, and you'd have to tape up the lights. Come on somebody, because they're liable to split and pop and break. Come on somebody, but they were singing for you to notice them. They were singing for you to applaud them. Come on church, hallelujah. You know you've seen it, amen. In modern Christendom today, some worship services has become nothing more than a concert. Come on, we got to flash the lights, got to get the smoke machine going, got to turn the lights out. Hey man, God delivered me from places that look like that. Come on somebody. Well, somebody's thinking, well, he's a little too old-timey. Yeah, Lord, keep me that way, keep me that way. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. I'm telling you, you may not have the latest art. You may not have the latest technology. But I think some with the new has got away from the old. What happened? Hallelujah, to just worshiping God. Some think they can't worship unless they got a piano, unless they got an instrument playing, unless they got somebody famous to come and sing. My God! The famous one is here. Jesus, the one that saved your soul. Save my soul. Look at your neighbor and say, I can play. I got a 10-string instrument. Look at him and say, I can play in any key. Come on. David was a master, skillfully at playing a harp. But when his wife ridiculed him as he danced before the Ark of the Covenant, he didn't have no harp in his hand. Come on, somebody. His instrument was his feet. Glory. He just danced before the Lord with all of his might. 2 Samuel 6 and 14. Come on, church. Hallelujah. What's your excuse? Hallelujah. Who cares if we got a sound system? Who cares if we got somebody to sing? Can you clap your hands? Can you open your mouth? Can you say hallelujah? It's what Paul and Silas did. Y'all be careful on the front pew. I'll shampoo the carpet and sometimes the people as well. I spit and they won't do that ever. But they're chained in walls. Look at your neighbor and say, but they're about to get off the chain. Because they start praying. and they start singing. You know, when you ain't got no audience but rats and roaches and other prisoners in a dark, deep dungeon of a prison up to your waist in human waste, you know what you got's for real. I've been a drummer since I was 12. I'm about to be 44. Before I got saved, I played my drums for a living. Hello? I met famous people doing it. I got paid to do it. When I got saved, I've played in every kind of group you can think of, gospel that you can imagine. Hello? There ain't nothing, there ain't a style of it I can't play to this very day. I don't mainly have to much practice with anybody. I can just play because I've done it. I've done went there. Hallelujah. And I still love to. Praise God. Praise God. But listen, when Paul and Silas was in that prison, they didn't have no drum to beat on. Let's say like me and the pastor with our archbishop. We got. Hey, watch out, leave that. Hallelujah. Praise God. Sister Connie's fault. Praise God. You ordered that brownie last night. Praise God. It's that brownie spirit. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But they didn't have no instruments to play. But I imagine old Paul thinking, I ain't got a tambourine, but I got a chain. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Now he's got his feet going silent with him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. They couldn't get their hands together, but they could. Look at your neighbor and say, you ought to give him a praise. I knew when I was a teenager and I was beatboxing, it was going to come in sometime in the ministry for me. And there's somebody shout, they shaking. They got a shaking praise. And all of a sudden, earthquake. God says, all right, I'm about to get in your shaking. I'm about to shake with your shaking. Look at your neighbor and say, if you'll get him, you'll shake. That means if you'll give him what you got, whatever you got to praise him with. Some of you feel like you're that way. You're so chained up, but use your chains then, my God. Use the darkness. Use the amplification of the prison place you in. Because I'm telling you, God don't need a key to get where you are. He don't need open door. He walks through walls. And they're praising God. And the earth begins to shake. All of a sudden, chains start breaking. Fetters start opening. And now it ain't, it's. Hey, hallelujah, their hands is free. The prison gates open, the doors open, because the foundation of the prison is put off its foundation. You know what that means to me? You can go tear that door off right there, beat it to death, tear it off. You can go find another one the right size and put it right back in its place. But if the foundation of this house ever gets messed up, you won't put that door back. You know why? When they prayed and sang and the earthquake come and the Holy Ghost said, there's a jailbreak about to take place here tonight. Look at your neighbor and say, I feel a release date. It's just that simple. Look at your neighbor and say, a Holy Ghost jailbreak in this house. If you'll praise him, if you'll give him glory, if you'll come before him with this kind of thanksgiving, because some of you, where you're at in life, you're ready for it, because it's dark. It's been harder than it's ever been. Hell's fought you harder than hell's ever come against you. Now you're ready to give him a in the same. Because God said, this is what I've been waiting on so I could shake the earth. God's getting ready to shake somebody's earthen experience. But God said, there's a praise I want to hear tonight out of your dilemma, out of your prison places, out of the places of your captivity, in the places where it's been so dark in your life and you've wondered at my wonders. God said, there's a praise tonight if you'll give it to me. Come on. if you'll bring it to me. If you'll bring it to me tonight, if you'll get it out of your spirit and out of your belly and give it to me tonight, God said, I'll come to your rescue. And not only will I open the prison gate, but God said, I'll take the prison foundation and so offset it that this prison place, you'll never walk in again. You'll never go behind these bars again. Somebody shout, welcome to a jailbreak. Glory. Now what are you gonna do? Hey, yeah. Brianna, scroll through that there tablet until you find where it says I've been delivered. Because God said we don't need even no instruments live played tonight, because God says every one of us are at our instrument right now. Have you forgot? He's gave you a built-in horn. It's called your esophagus. Come on, somebody. You ought to let your diaphragm push a praise out right now. Here's how you can start. You may just have to close your eyes because you don't want to be distracted by nobody. But God said, if you'll get your praise personal to me right now, if you'll find a praise that's real personal right now, hallelujah, and begin to praise me like this personally, hallelujah, and forget about everybody around you. God says tonight, you'll be surprised when you leave. That sickness you had will be gone. That ailment you had will be gone. Some of you, that depression and that oppression and that thing that makes you want to kill yourself and tells you all the time you shouldn't live, you might as well just go ahead and waste away. That thing that tells you you're ugly and you're worthless and God don't even love you and God don't even care and ain't nobody for you, you ought to shout over the voice of this adversary in this line tonight. You ought to shout God's praise. You ought to lift him up, give him glory. Come on, make a noise. Make a noise. You ain't got to make a song. Make a noise. Make a noise. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord on your lands. Psalms 100 verse 1. You find it? Yeah, turn it up. I'm going to pull out some stuff from the late 90s Brownsville Revival. Back in a hopeless
lie. I'm talking about
hallelujah. Back in a hopeless lie. I'm telling you, revival's at the Bridgeford Church of God. It ain't cause Marvin Booth here. Come on, baby girl. I know you couldn't stand it. My God, don't you be found just sitting. You may not dance like somebody else, or you may not feel like you can get all out like somebody else, but you don't need to pattern your praise after them anyhow. But whatever you do, don't stay quiet.
And Satan is convincing you in your mind.
You may not leave from where you at, but you lift him up. Come on. Psalms 81 says praise was a law, a statute unto Israel. It weren't God's suggestion. You hear preachers all the time say praise him like you want to. You keep praising him like you want to, and you're going to miss God. Praising like God said to. Clap your hands. Shout. Lift your hands. Dance before him. Get loud. Oh, yeah. My God, I feel Holy Ghost. Come on, ain't Jesus worthy? Ain't he worthy? It's because I know. Somebody shout, this ain't hype, this is help. David said, I'm going to praise him for the help of his countenance. Psalms 42 and 5. Come on, the world looks on and they don't understand. They popping pills, trying to get drunk, but our pill's a praise pill. Come on, his presence is your joy. And his presence is fullness of joy. Psalm 16:11.
I've been delivered by the
I've been delivered. Thank you, Lord.
You know, he saved someone I know this close to death.
Come on, if you just leave from where you are.
With asthma back his breath.
And start lifting him up, he'll bring you out.
went from sin, he set you free.
Come on, you can't stay long if you lift him up.
You're free. You are free indeed.
Yeah, I've been delivered.
I've been delivered.
I've been delivered.
I've been delivered.
I've been delivered. Brother Marvin, is it that simple? Your old time Pentecostals doing what? Set me free. I'm so glad.
Jesus set me free. I'm so glad.
Let me praise you. When you brought my soul out of prison. Psalms 142 says. Come on, if he's brought your soul out of prison, you ought to praise him.
Jesus set me free. I'm so glad. Jesus set me free.
No.
Done with that.
Free, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
In the name of Jesus. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty.
You may look at somebody up on this stage.
2 Corinthians 3:17.
A suit on, you think they've never had a problem in their life. There was a time when Satan had me so bound up, and he convinced me there was no way for me to be free. And I was sitting in the church. But that rascal is alive.
Free. Free. To whom the Son sets free. It's free indeed, John 8:36.
Take the sin out of your life and walk away from it. There's freedom for you. There's freedom for you.
There's freedom for you.
There's freedom for you.
There's freedom for you.
And there's joy for you. I said there's joy for you.
Yeah.
There's joy for you.
There's joy for you.
There's joy for you. There's joy for you.
Yeah, Jesus set me free. I'm so glad. Jesus set me. Go ahead, brother.
I'm so glad. Jesus set me free. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
You know Satan had me bound, but Jesus set me free.
Satan had me bound. Jesus set me free.
Satan had me bound.
Come on, will you not revive us again? That we may rejoice in thee. Psalms 86:5.
Hallelujah. You know that makes you want to just shake the religion off and dance.
Shake the religion off. Thank you, Lord.
The devil had on me. He ain't got no blood.
Use my girl, Lord.
I've been delivered.
I've been delivered.
One more time.
Go ahead, baby. He sang Holy Ghost here as he was out of the church.
I've been delivered. You know the hold the devil had on me. He ain't got no blood.
Play one more time. I've been delivered. Holy, holy. Come on, he's moving. You ain't waiting on him to move.
Jesus touched the blind man and made him see.
You won't get your healing tonight because I touch you.
He cast demons.
You won't get your miracle tonight because I lay hands on you. God said, I want my people to touch me again. Some of us are so busy waiting on his touch that we're missing that he wants us to touch him. He said, as many as touched him, we're made whole.
He made the blind man
Mark 6:56. Hey!
He brought hope back in a hopeless life.
Whew, thank you, Holy Ghost.
I'm talking about
fire.
He brought
you're
hope
fire.
Back in a hopeless
you're fire.
Life.
Our God. Hallelujah. Touch him, Holy
Ghost. Oh, let me testify to you.
Use him, Lord. You're fire. You're fire, Jesus. Use him, King Jesus.
And Satan is convincing you.
You know who ought to be up here before anybody? Those that's in leadership positions in the church.
That's a good.
If you hold some position in the church as a leader, you ought to be doing some leading right now. You ought to be at the front of the army. Where Jehoshaphat's praisers are. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Man, I feel him. If you'll feel after him, you'll feel him. You gotta move with him.
And the reason I can tell
if you'll move with him, you'll experience a move of him. If you know him,
I've been delivered. The hold the devil had on me, he ain't got no more. I've been delivered.
Rich, I can't dance like that. You'd be surprised what you might do.
I've been delivered.
I dare you by the Holy Ghost. My God, just get out of your seat and just start raising your hands and see what happens. Thank you, Lord. I don't know what to do. I feel him so much. I've got to go.
Save someone I know this close to death. He gave a boy with asthma back.
Hold it.
But the greatest new hit.
Come on, practice his word tonight.
From sin he set you free.
How much more do I got to preach?
Jesus set you free.
You are free indeed. I've been delivered.
The hold the devil had on me. He ain't got no more.
I've been delivered. Come on, nothing can take the place of this. This is that.